It is playoff time. We're here at Kellogg Field. Falcons taking on Kettle Run in a semi-final district game. Winner to advance to the finals. We are ready for the start. And that would be Kirsten Settle, number 10. One of the anchor players of the team, a captain. And she gets us off to a good start with a nice push up field. Bit of a conversation about who had the ball. I guess the nice spinning pass, looks for Lott, finds her right in the spot where she likes to go to work, and a dish off. Oh my goodness, and that was a good start. A shot whistled left by Kirsten Settle. We're just minutes underway. That will be a 16-yard hit, and they're very, very precise about what they want, these referees. We're in district playoff mode. Falkir has won two previous contests against Kettle Run by single-digit scores. They've shut them out, and we've got a penalty corner.
Penalty corner, Falkir.
Falkir has looked sharp in their last several outings. And they're playing these one game at a time. Sends it out. Got it to Settle. And a nice bouncer off the pads. And they got one more try at it.
Penalty corner, Falkir.
Another good send, a pass off, and another good shot. A little too much air. Fuck your ball, lock on it. She'll go to an immediate start. You'll hear the voice of Coach Brooke Settle cutting through the night air, exhorting her team at various intervals about what they should be doing, especially if they do not perform as she hopes. That time she was asking for cuts. I bet she'll get them next time. Okay, Kettle Run on the attack now with a good push. Sends it across. Finds Shaw. Lock with a spin move. Cuts back. And into the circle. No score, 9 minutes remaining in this first period. Falcons looking sharp. That time, Kreider to Mackenzie Settle, number 7. She broke into the starting lineup as a freshman. had a two-goal performance evening recently, so she's definitely a contributor. Usually takes a little while for Falkir to heat up their game. And based on their one loss record, they earned the home game advantage this evening. They're 7-1 in the Northwestern District, along with Meridian. A good, solid strike. And a send. No score. Falkir has been penetrating. This will be Settle. Kirsten with a good push. Down low. Bit of a collision there. Kettle Run mounting a little charge here. This is Locke, who automatically goes into startup mode. Good stop and a good resend. Settle. Perfect. Lily Ratana Rodriguez with a nice play there. We're winding down to 4 minutes in this quarter. No score. Kettle Run moving into position. And a big send. And if you're wondering, would it be a physical game? The answer will be yes. Just expect that. There's 34 remaining. Gorg. This will be Locke. She'll look to center in. Boy, that was right in the wheelhouse of Kirsten Settle, but she could not get her stick on it properly, so it'll turn over. 1 minute, 45 seconds remaining. Falkir looking to get a penalty corner here if they can. They're pretty good about doing that as the quarter draws down. Gorg. Settle knows that getting to that penalty circle is the goal at the moment. Urgency is the call from the coaching bench for Falkir. This time she goes short, corner, out in front. Falkir still in play here. Okay. The coaches have spoken. Will the players respond? That's the question as they come out for the start of the second quarter. And another good send upfield, and the Falcons are in pursuit. Locke. Right where she likes to work from. Falcons are drawing the ball down low into the corners, something we call the weeds. It's okay if the ball goes there, but I don't think we should take the ball there. That's my personal opinion. Falcons are much better when they break down their opponent at the top of the circle. And I have a sneaking suspicion Settle will say something similar. A good drive. Locke. Almost unstoppable in the midfield. Intercepted by Settle. Gorg, oh man, she was wetting her lips.
Penalty corner, clock here.
Ascend in. In my opinion, we should be in the center of the field by this point. We're down low into the corner. No score. We're midway through this second period. Penalty corner, Falk here. Kettle Run is packing their defensive perimeter. Gorg tried to get clear, but could not get a clear shot. A good shot. Penalty corner, Falk here. One more time. A good shot. Misses. Yeah! Kettle Run putting on a charge here. Still no score. And a good defensive play. Locke is hunting on the ball. Penalty corner, Kettle Run, and a clear. Walker needs to stay in the middle and not keep going over there. Why are you going there?
There we go.
Penalty corner, Falkier. Falkier out in front. Oh, and rejected. Penalty corner, falls here one more time. A good drive. Okay, we started the second half. Falkiers getting their chances, but they haven't been able to make anything happen. There's your shot.
There we go.
Penalty corner, Falkier.
Here we go.
Another one for Fauquier, penalty corner. Penalty corner, Fauquier, one more time. Allison Long with a good and that is a yellow card. Getting deep into this third quarter, no score. Fauquier coming out. So Kettle Run has got some players out of the game, and the referees are still working on this. Referees have called a referee timeout. They're talking to both captains, and okay, we are resuming play after the referee's timeout. It appears Kettle Run is down two players. And a long drive. Fauquier with a tremendous advantage here. And yet we still go to the corner. Why, I don't know. But that's what we apparently want to do. Kettle Run players are using their bodies instead of their sticks, and so Locke has been carded, and we're seeing a repeat of behaviors from previous games here. Thank you. fourth period. We have no score here in the district semifinal. Kettle Run making a game of it here at Kellekin Field. Fauquier is, I don't know what Fauquier is right now. Not the team that we've seen, accustomed to seeing. And they find themselves in a very physical game here. Finally, they got a ball. Across. Fauquier leading 1-0 off the goal by Shaw. And we got Locke back in off the bench. Challenge down low.
Oh,
Fauquier is bunching, doing things that I find peculiar. Anyways. Seven minutes, 42 seconds left. McKenna Kupka, with her best chance, was right there. There's a lot of borderline calls that could be cards. She's getting a little lecture. Oh, she's getting the card. Another yellow. I mean, this has been a very yellow game. We're under 4 minutes remaining, and a timeout on the field. Okay, we are back off the timeout. Send in by Gord. Yeah! with one of our seniors, and you've advanced to the district final. So tell us a little bit about the game from what you saw tonight. It was a tough game, wasn't it?
It was a tough game. I think everyone fought really hard. There's definitely some things that we're going to work on practice tomorrow, but we're definitely really excited to go out and be Meridian.
Well, very good, and you looked like you were close to a couple goals tonight.
Yeah, just had to
You were really close. Okay, well, we wish you good luck on Thursday. Hear from the manager.
You don't.
Because the manager is the most important job on the whole team. So tell us a little bit about your job this year and what you do to help the team succeed.
Oh, well, I work a lot with the lovely goalies here. I spend a lot of practices with them, doing a lot of drills, setting up warm-ups, and then just like giving my input where I can. And then on the game, I'm helping during warm-ups, helping with ball pickup, setting up the field, moving stuff all around, and then emotional support a little bit, and then taking stats, obviously, and then defending my players when need be. So.
Very good. Well, that's a multitasking job you got there. Well, thank you. I guess we're going to need your help on Thursday.
Oh, yes, absolutely. I will be there.
All right. Well, very good.
I will stand on business. Don't even worry, Miss Miriam.